What is up, it's Mikey, and today we're going to go over the Black Spindle. It's basically the Black Hammer 2.0. It's got a really cool perk, White Nail. Rapidly landing 3 precision shots will refill the magazine from your reserves. And this is really cool when you got stationary bosses that have a weak point, and you can just aim on them and fire over and over until you run out of ammo. Okay, so it saves a little time in that regard. And so the only way you can get it is by playing the daily heroic story when it's lost to light. That's the only way you can get it. So hopefully you guys got the day off whenever that pops up. Oh, and one thing I highly recommend is do this with 2 other people. Use Destiny LFG. That's what I use. I did this with 2 random people I never played with before. It's pretty much impossible solo. So destinylfg.com.net. Use whatever you like, but it's pretty much impossible solo. So let's get into it. So this mission, it's the first half is insanely easy. You gotta do 2 minutes of just running, just run past everything until you get to Bax the Gravekeeper. Okay, he's that big ogre. He'll always pop up in the back. Go ahead and take him down. And once that happens, you know, do what it tells you to do. Take a chunk of the rock out. And then from there, you gotta run. So we're gonna head through the Chamber of Night and keep on running. Just run past all these guys until you get to the World's Grave. Have someone kill the guys at the door while someone grabs the ball to enable the door to open. And once that's done, we're gonna keep running past the enemies until we get to the second door. All right, so it's pretty much the same thing. You kind of want to do this really fast. All you guys cannot wipe. At least one person must stay alive. If you all die, you're gonna have to do the mission all over again if you're going for the exotic sniper. All right, so once you get the door open, one person needs to make it through the Temple of Crota. And what we're gonna do is head on over to the Fallen Ship. Okay, so basically after that second door, you just hug the left side and we're gonna head on up until we get to Dusk Warm. From there, we want to take the elevator up once all you guys are here and just play the mission as fast as possible. And ideally, you're gonna have about 6 or 7 minutes on the clock. You really want to hope for 7 minutes. Your priority is definitely those wizards because they spawn in the Taken Thrall. Those things are annoying, so have someone with a void weapon or a void attack and take them out. A void sword can definitely work out. That really worked out good for me. And once you take out those really annoying snipers, you know, there's different methods to take them out. You can have someone go up there with a shotgun. You can just shoot them from below. You can snipe them. Really annoying, but like I said, you wanna be around, I'd say 6.5, 7 minutes. All right, very, very important. It will really help you a lot if you have a hunter with the Night Stalker class. And if he has a black hole enabled, the void anchor has increased range, lasts significantly longer, and can tether more targets. And he has Vanish in Smoke. That is where the smoke grenades, when you throw them down, they turn everyone invisible that it hits. So once you've got your super, and once you got the smoke bombs, you throw it down on the ground. So your whole party has been vanished in smoke. You guys all pull your swords, that's another thing. Everyone needs swords, and then you head straight to Drivix. Everyone rushes him. That is when the Night Stalker pulls out his super, hits him, throws a grenade if you can, and everyone just goes crazy. It is possible to get a 5-hit combo if you jump up and hit the right trigger. It does an animation cancel. If you're familiar with using the sword on Crota, it's the same concept, okay? And you guys just use your swords until he kills you, okay? Everyone's gonna die. And when you respawn in, that is when everyone focuses on the adds, the additional enemies, take out their spawn points, those big orbs, kill everybody and build up to your next super, okay? So once you've got your next super, once you've killed a lot of those enemies, then it's time to do the same thing. Throw down the smoke bomb, you guys are all invisible, and then you could charge Drivix and just mash away with your swords. Same thing, you guys are all going to die. All right, so when you spawn in, no need to wait for a super. You guys can all bum rush him again with your swords. He will definitely die. He'll be so low on health. And then you guys, from that point on, can just scramble and go as fast as you can to take out all the additional enemies. All right, it's gonna take some communication. You guys need to talk about where the big guys are, where enemies are at. And if everything works out, you should kill everything with at least 10 seconds remaining. It's cutting it really close. And when you guys all do that, you get 15 legendary marks and the black spindle. So there's all sorts of methods, but this is the one that worked best for us, bum rushing with the sword. Some people like to throw down a bubble on the boss and then hit him with the sword. That can work too. But basically doing a suicide mission with the swords, killing him right off the bat, that seems to work the best, and then focus on all the ads. Anyways, if you want to play with me, open lobbies, live streams, Twitter, Facebook, links down below. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. See you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Destiny tips, tricks, info, glitches, all kinds of stuff. It's a playlist. I try to keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side, got the same thing, but for Call of Duty, info, tips, tricks, news, all sorts of stuff, you can click on the screen or links down below.